Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the week 8 edition of Plays and Fades, obviously Halloween themed, Shattered Dreams production. We'll get right into it with the quarterback that we like this week, Cam. Oh, Cam. Last time we saw Cam Newton, it was in Chicago, and he looked horrible. The entire Panther offense looked horrible. But a lot of deja vu with this game. Last time Cam was in a similar situation in week 4 against the New England Patriots, he gassed them, close to 30 FanDuel points. At the time, New England was the worst defense DVOA against the pass. Now he's playing the Tampa Bay Bucks. They're the worst defense against the pass. Next up is a running back I like this week also. I'm gonna give you two, but the first one, Le'Veon Bell. Second one, back to McCoy. Might as well have left him there from last week. We'll start off with Le'Veon Bell. On the road against the Detroit Lions, who are coming off a bye week. Detroit a couple weeks back gave up 22 FanDuel points to Mark Ingram. You don't need to worry about the home road splits with Le'Veon Bell. He's pretty solid anywhere he plays. Even more so on the road. I think his salary is going to scare people off a little bit, over 9K. But I like Le'Veon this week. They figured out what it takes to get W's in the NFL. Just keep feeding Le'Veon. Next up, LeSean McCoy. And if you played him last week, you're welcome. Play him again this week. Very similar matchup. Oakland is one of the worst teams at defending the run this year. And also on the bottom five at defending running backs out the backfield. Charles Clay is still out. Jordan Matthews couldn't catch with two hands. Now he has a broken thumb with a special glove on, and you expect me to trust that? No, sir. Give me McCoy coming out the backfield. Give me McCoy for at least 25 carries in a game that Buffalo is favored in. Now, it might be hard for you to fit both of these guys in because of their salary being so high, unless you're super confident in some wide receivers that you find value in. But for the most part, I definitely start my lineups with one of these two guys. Let's move on over to the wide receiver that we like this week, Mike Evans. Mike Evans has scored a touchdown in each of his last two games, and he's getting peppered with targets. His worst game this year as far as targets is 8. And Jameis Winston just has goggles for him. Next up, another wide receiver that I like this week. And it's time to hop on board because this guy always catches fire in the second half of the year. Dougie Baldwin. Now, before you call me crazy, let me finish. Doug Baldwin is very similar to Antonio Brown in the sense that these guys are pretty much matchup proof. The way Seattle uses Doug Baldwin is similar to how the Pittsburgh Steelers use Antonio Brown. Doug Baldwin primarily lines up in the slot, and this week against the Houston Texans at home, he's probably going to draw Kareem Jackson. According to Pro Football Focus, Kareem Jackson is the second worst slot corner in the NFL. Doug Baldwin lines up 75% of his routes in the slot. Play Baldwin this week. I even love pairing him with Russell Wilson. Moving on over to the tight end position. All my friends that play yearly fantasy with me, I am the commissioner of our league. They know how I feel about the tight end position. There's no tight end position in our league. We play with two flex. So this is going to be a surprise to them when I say you should play two tight ends this week. Jordan Reed and Hunter Henry. We'll start off with Jordan Reed. Last year on Thanksgiving, Jordan Reed scored 2 touchdowns against the Dallas Cowboys with a busted up shoulder, elbow, knees, toes, you name it, this guy was hobbled, and he still found pay dirt twice last year. On Monday Night Football, it was Jordan Reed's coming out party. Last year, it took strong consideration whether or not we should play Jordan Reed at around $7,000 on FanDuel. Now we're getting him still at a discount. In a matchup against the Dallas Cowboys, who are one of the worst teams at defending the opposing tight end, I love Jordan Reed this week. The other tight end that you see over here is Hunter Henry, and he's become a staple over here in the play section. Going up against the New England Patriots this week, who have gotten gassed by a couple tight ends this year, Hunter Henry is featured in the game with the second highest point total on the slate. My favorite thing about Hunter Henry is he runs a route on 80% of the snaps that he's on the field. So when Hunter Henry's on the field, he's running around. Phillip Rivers, as much as he loves Antonio Gates, has figured out for them to win in this league, now it's a young man's game. And Hunter Henry is the younger of the two, and he's also the better of the two right now in their career. Play Hunter Henry. Last up on the play section, the defense I'm playing this week, the Philadelphia Eagles. In a game where Philadelphia is favored by close to 14 points against the San Francisco 49ers, there's something in the DFS community that scares people away from paying up for the most expensive defense. It's like paying up for the most expensive kicker. It's just not cool to do. San Francisco is still starting CJ Beathard, rookie quarterback. Against this pass rush, I could see him throwing a couple away. Maybe even returning one to the house. Moving on over to the fades section for this week. It's a quarterback that everyone loves and at this moment is my MVP. But not this week, Carson. Carson Wentz is my fade this week. And it's pretty simple. I think his ownership is going to be through the roof. Similar price to Cam Newton, only $100 less. I think Cam is a phenomenal pivot off Wentz. Now here's the thing. Always remember, the fades doesn't mean that he's going to dud. It doesn't mean that he's going to score 7 points. Carson Wentz might score 20 points, but he might see 45% ownership, especially off that Monday Night Football game that he had. I love Cam at a cheaper price than Carson Wentz. I also love Russell Wilson this week. If you're playing in big tournaments, I wouldn't play Carson Wentz. Piggybacking off the Philadelphia Eagles-San Francisco game, the running back I'm fading this week, El Guapo, Carlos Hyde. San Francisco is a 14-point underdog in this game. What does that tell you? According to game script, San Francisco is going to have to abandon the run and throw from behind. Though Carlos Hyde is seeing a career high in targets out the backfield, I still don't trust him, and I'm not confident in playing him this week. A wide receiver that I am not playing this week unless he was minimum salary, and he's not. Coming off that big Thursday Night Football game, Amari Cooper. Amari Cooper might be the highest owned wide receiver on the slate this week. Dude had a monster game on Thursday Night Football, and the whole world saw it. Those standalone games always inflate people's ownerships. Everyone's gonna chase that Thursday Night Football game. They're gonna pull up Amari Cooper's game log, and they're gonna see 44, 43 points, depending on the site that you were on. He's actually priced with his teammate, Michael Crabtree, who a lot of people think is the number one receiver on the Raiders. I'd much rather go there. He's a lot safer. Next up, the wide receiver that I'm fading this week, Terrell Pryor. Terrell Pryor, we've been waiting for 8 weeks, man. It's just not panning out. And now you're losing snaps to Josh Doctson. Terrell Pryor didn't even see a snap in the first half of that Monday Night Football game. A lot of funky shit going on over in Washington. Last but not least, the defense that I'm going to fade this week, the Houston Texans. Houston is going on the road into Seattle, one of the most hostile environments in the NFL. People still think that the Seahawks struggle offensively, and that's just not true. Especially coming off a bye week, they lit up the Giants the past week. And Houston is nowhere near the same defense they were. No Merciless, no JJ Watt, and Cushing's out with PEDs. A lot of people tend to see the name and just gravitate to him when they're playing DFS. I'm not playing the Texans this week. So there you have it. Plays and fades for week 8, Halloween edition. If you want to hear more about DFS, I have a podcast called Degeneration Bets. It's in the bio beneath. Every Friday, I drop a DFS episode where I talk about my favorite plays and fades of that particular week. And if you want to find me, LandVM10 on Twitter. Happy Halloween and good luck.